On this channel, we explore one topic at a time about Nepal. And today, we're exploring the Budhanilakanta Temple, or the Sleeping Vishnu Temple. If Nepal is on your bucket list, you'll want to subscribe and hit the notification bell. Check out our channel and feel free to ask a question if it isn't already listed. Here's something you'll often see at Hindu temples: people of other faiths being drawn to these sacred places. We met these two darling Islamic children enjoying the sight without their mother, which is also fine. I asked if they were hungry, and the little girl assured me that they were not. I never give money to a child, but I'm always happy to take them to buy some lentils to take home. Be sure to buy it in bulk or open the package. Sometimes they return it for part of the price. Finally, a temple without 108 steps. This is a Vishnu temple, but you can see many other gods here. I even met a Hare Krishna devotee here. One good point about this temple site is that there is no admission fee. You'll often see this goddess near schools. This is Saraswati, the goddess of knowledge. Doesn't it seem that sacred places, regardless of the religion, can be such vortexes of peace? It certainly seems to be the case at these temples and stupas here in Nepal. This being during the pandemic, these signs are to encourage visitors to wear a mask, which most people willingly do. If you want to go down to view the idol and take a picture, you'll need to leave your shoes here. There is also a donation box to help maintain the grounds. As you can see, this temple is quite nice and clean. The huge Vishnu idol, one of the most impressive idols in Nepal. The actual idol is the largest stone idol in Nepal, but it's said to float in the pool. This idol seems to have mysterious origins as well. Some say it was found by a farmer, while others say a king commissioned it. Another legend about the temple as well. It's said that if a king of Nepal were to go to this temple, he would die. You'll often see the swastika at temples. Please don't think it has anything to do with anti-Semitism. This is an auspicious symbol for good luck. Brahmin children tend to the idol, and these are the only ones who are able to touch it for the most part. If you come to Nepal in October or November, you may want to check the Nepali calendar for the Hari Bodhini Ekadasi Mela. Thousands of pilgrims come here for this celebration. If you're here during this time, look at our pinned comment for a group excursion to this festival. Thank you. It's incredible to see the immense size. It's said to be floating in the water, and there is actually a scientific possibility for that. The stone is quite light. It is said to be from the 7th century, but notice how clear the details still are. Notice these flags at this temple. You can find this flag in Bhaktapur as well. This is the original flag of Nepal and was the inspiration to the flag we see today. The Nepali flag is the only national flag that isn't in the shape of a rectangle or square. Maybe you've wondered why all the bell ringing at Hindu temples. Ringing the bell is said to send the prayer up to heaven. You'll often see this type of enclosure at temples. Weddings and other ceremonies are done in this. Use the police post to help if you have any problem. If you enjoy music and would like to join in with some local spiritual music, they have musical ceremonies 2 to 3 times a day here in this building. There is a healthy monkey population here. Try to avoid feeding them. They can become aggressive when you run out of food. 3 people every day get bit by monkeys in Kathmandu, statistically. This is Kumar, Ganesh's brother. Did you even know Lord Ganesh had a brother? Best part of visiting one of these temples, other than for pure spiritual enjoyment, is to shop at the local nearby stores. You can find some interesting things at excellent prices. The merchants are kind and friendly even when they don't speak English. When you ask how much something costs, they will often get out the calculator and show you the number. After our first visit to this temple, we took a hike to the Shivapuri National Forest, which is nearby. You'll enjoy becoming familiar with this area if you're planning on doing a 10-day Vipassana silent meditation. You can take a bus or taxi here, and then walk up or take another bus to the Shivapuri entrance, which is where you can visit the monastery prior to your stay if you like. If this interests you, just click on the end screen card to watch that video. Our Nepal Travel Guide is a growing collection of travel tips covering a wide variety of topics to help travelers to get more enjoyment out of their time here. If you're looking for the premier travel channel for Nepal, I know you'll find our travel tips for Kathmandu and Nepal to be both practical and culturally insightful. We feature best values you can find to help with budget travel, while helping you to get the most out of your time.